Hello Genshin lovers, this video all about artifact domains tips and tricks. Like, in this domain you should start here or you should fight here, etc, etc. Okay, let's get into it. I will solve them cause I don't have any friend can help me currently. So yeah. For first domain is Valley of Remembrance. We mostly farm it for scrolls, venti or healer characters, so this domain mainly for the support classes. There are some treasure hoarders and two fatu enemies inside, but they are a bit separated. So in the co-op mode we mostly want to see a venti in here, but venti is not a must cause we only need to lure them over one place. And animal traveler and scrolls can do it as well. So I recommend having a venti, scrolls or animal traveler is really helpful in here. Alright, I think I'll put a music in here and speed up the boring part. That's just for you. Don't forget that.
Where am I going now? Just falling over dreams. Now I'm just so far gone. This isn't what it seems. Taking me so damn long, it's fading from belief. I need to slow this down, it's burning from beneath. Come back.
I feel sad cause I cut the music in the middle, but don't worry, I will use the second half within here cause we are going to do the domain of Gyun, which is wet dream of the Ningguang Geo-Traveler and zombie users cause of the Archaic Petra. Domain has a cryo buffer in the middle which gives cryo buff to enemies and you need melt procs to delete it easily, but however the game decided to give a penalty for melt procs, that's why you should bring a healer with your team. And of course a pyro user to heal with your healer. Anyways, for free to play players, I recommend Ember cause she brings the pyro with her. And also you need an archer for the ruin hunter cause while it's flying you don't have much to do. Personally, I don't like archers, so even I suffer while waiting that ruin hunter go down, I won't use an archer in here. But seriously, I recommend bringing an archer is one of the best options in here. Alright, let's let the music do its own thing.
Down is burning.
Okay, actually I did one more run with Razer, but even without that the video is going to be really long, so I decided to not put this one in the video. And the next location is Hidden Palace of Zhou Formula. I'm pretty familiar with this domain because of the D-Log, and it was really painful. I did more than 300 runs and my D-Log still got really bad stats anyways. People come here for Crimson Witch of Flames, which is I think the best artifact other than Gladiator set for DPS characters. And generally domain drops low wall group pieces, which is not that useful for us. Okay, now the domain has a pyro buffer in the middle and it has a panel for proking overload, but the good thing is we don't need overload in here. Take your Barbara or Shinchui, or if you have your Mona it's even better. And for the god's sake, please take a cryo user like Chongyun or DPS Kaya. I mean, it's going to end before you see the second enemies if you don't take a cryo user. And Chongyun I think is the best option if the team has a lot of melee characters, or if the team don't has a lot of melee characters, pick at DPS Kaya. Okay, now it's time for the music. At least for that one I was able to cut the music with a good timing. Oh god, I feel like I'm getting used to it. But next part of the music is going to be a rapping part, so it will be a good fit for my next fight. I mean, it was going to be a boring one because of the domain and artifacts, because no one uses them. The next stop is going to be Midsummer Courtyard. Like, I didn't even know the name of the artifacts. I checked it on the internet while I'm editing the video. The main reason to come here is should be the Thundering Fury, which is pointless for me. This domain has a buffer in the middle too, and it's electro, so you should bring a cryo user, but proking a super conodot has a penalty again. And that's why you should also bring a healer, but if you have a Chi-Chi, I mean, she's cryo and healer at the same time, so why not? And you need a pyro damage dealer or any physical damage dealer as your main DPS in here. For free play players, they give a Xiangyin for free. You can use her as your main DPS. The domain not that difficult, just keep that in mind. There are two Fatui mages which has more electro resistance than other enemies. I won't go in details. I also have a guide video explains enemy resistances. So don't try to bring a heavy electro damage dealer to here like Lisa. And the mages also take more physical damage than other non-Fatui enemies. Alright, as Barbara said, let the show begin. Yeah,
to spit vicious. Release bombs and go tick, tick, boom, you blow me, that head missing. I'm a phenomenon, stacking cheese like it's Parmesan. Eight different flows, call me Octomom. I'm moving fast like the Autobahn, and I'm independent, so I'm not your fucking starving like it's Ramadan. Sick, twisted, gifted, can't copy, printed, can't hold me down. I shapeshift, I'm liquid, I killed this beat, I might get convicted. They know how I move, it was predicted. Persistent, spoke it into existence, so consistent, no assistance. Hear me once, become addicted. If I rap it, then I lift it, there's no cap when I be breaking this.
This ain't what you want, bitch, I'm a fucking phenomenon. What you want, bitch, I'm a fucking phenomenon.
That was fun. By the way, if you are still watching, you're a beautiful person. Thank you.
And please leave a like to increase my chance to see more people like you.
Alright. The next one, Clearpool and Mountain Cavern. Don't let the name fool you. Domain has not any pool in it. Yeah. This domain is really difficult if you try to do it in co-op, because there's a way to do it and most of the people don't know it. I will explain, don't worry. But first, why do we go there? This domain has two really good artifacts. I mostly like the Nobles of Light set because it increases Bennett's utility a lot and also gives him a little damage bonus on his burst. And the other artifact is really useful for physical damage dealers. Now, how to co-op or solo this domain? You should go right corner, that's it. Go to right corner and let the host start the challenge. And he should rush back to corner as well. This makes you only take aggro of the cryo and pyro mages. And these are easy when it comes to breaking their shields. Always bring one hydro, one pyro and one cryo. Actually fourth member doesn't really matter. I died while I'm soloing, but you know I'm soloing, so I'm lacking DPS in here. So normally you don't even need a healer in here if you can dodge the attacks. But for consistency, bring a healer as fourth member of team. And now music. Normally this would be the end of the video, but they recently added one more artifact domain, and if you haven't unlocked this one yet, the next part is going to be a spoiler for you. I warned you, so I'm not responsible for the things happens after here. It's been a good thing they have finally realized they have cryo and hydro damage dealers but don't have any DPS artifacts can fit them. I mean the artifacts are not super good things, but two pieces are usable. Now there are a couple of things to unlock this domain, but we will consider you have already unlocked it. Now in here you still be accumulating shearcode, and there are two basic mechanics with shearcode in domain. You will see orange and blue root, blue color two flows. Blue ones are more common and orange ones are a bit less common. Now blue ones accelerates shearcode accumulation and orange ones decreases shearcode, makes you a bit more warmer. In here, bringing pyro makes everything much easier since there are two enemies and both of them are cryo. Focus on the abyss mesh at first because it has a lot of AoE control and accelerates shearcode accumulation and things and stuff and blah blah blah. The mage is really annoying, trust me. So focusing on the mage at first is the best option. In co-op mode, even if your teammates not focusing on the mage, use your pyro character, take the shield off and stun it while smashing it to death. Then you can start attacking the lava shield. That thing might be bigger but not the biggest deal. And let the final part of the music begin. It's been the longest video I have edited. Whew, took a long time. I mean, I'm new at editing videos, but that one took my whole day. Not joking, my whole day went to this video. But it was fun. And I also hope you had fun while watching it. Alright, that's it for now. Thanks for watching, leave a like, and remember there's a guy who makes videos. See you next week.